Welcome back to Let's Play Amberstar Blind on the Amiga and stuff with English words. Anyway, we're back. I realized how to, or I remembered actually, it's been a while since I had to pick a lock or open a lock with a key, I think was what I did last time. You simply go like this, and since we don't have a key that fits, that's the villa key. I wonder what happened. Just nothing. You open the lock with the pass key. It's not a pass key. It's a lock pick. Or maybe pass key is what they call it in other countries? In this chest, you find a golden wine goblet and a few empty flasks. Indeed. So, what I found a tip, actually, in a walkthrough, in the beginning of a walkthrough, I don't know if this qualifies as a spoiler or not, but if you go up to Chandra and hand him empty potion flasks, he will make potions for you. I think it's one of two different kinds. What I'm looking for is healing potions. I'm not sure if that's the kind that he makes, to tell you the truth. I think Silk might have the empty flasks, so I'm just gonna give those to him. And this, I'm pretty sure, is the wine goblet that Orlando wants. So I'll give that to him too. Or not, because he's full. I guess he didn't have that then. Or he was already full. Either way, Gribben can have it. Kinda curious now. Okay, I guess he was already full. Anyone else have empty flasks? Gribben has one. Of course the dog won't have any. Not even Drobaneer has. You know what it is? No, we do use the map. I was thinking that maybe when we use the potions, we'd have the flask left over. That would be cool, wouldn't it? Of course, you'd end up with, like, thousands of empty flasks. But it makes sense. You would drink the potion and have the flask left over. Okay, so unfortunately now we have to make our way completely out of here because Spike is hurting, and we only have one potion left. So I'm just gonna see if we can make some potions. Yeah, we only have this big one. And I only want to use that in case of emergency. So we're gonna make our way out of here. There is a second floor, so let's see if we can complete our quest. Orlando's right out there. I'm gonna head out. And I'll see you guys when we find Orlando. Greetings. If I just give it to him, I'm gonna say something to him. I think I'm just gonna say something to him. He's not the one who has it. Wine goblet. Many thanks. Who would have thought that there are secret spaces in my wine cellar? Goblins have settled there? Unbelievable. Here, take this as thanks for your help. I received this key from my grandfather, and he, in turn, from his. He always said that something valuable can be found with this key, but I have no time to search for it. Perhaps you'll be able to find the treasure, and the key can help you with your adventure. Good luck with it. Old key. Hold on a second. Here we go. Oh, wait. Did he have money to give me, or was that my money? 567, that was his money, alright. Okay, we have a key. Oh, I went... Oh, that's fine. I have to go through here, that's right. I need to rest anyway. Might as well keep you guys in the loop for a little bit. We went to a dungeon. Another wine cellar. Underneath the dancing dragon that had a key. But there's also a key on the way to the Paladin's Guild, or Paladin's Guild. So I might try using it there, because we can level up Griban. And we have a lot of gold. It's awesome. Thumbs up. Thumbs up to gold. And rest. Griban gets 16 points. Tragic gets 36 power points. Spike 27. Trobonir 51. A resident beast. Alright. Okay, we are back up to full, and that's to sleep more, which we don't need. Wait a second. I know there's a way out of here. Here we go. Yeah. Oh wait, we're in Crystal. The Paladin's Guild is here. Sure. Yeah. Now the key, I think, is not completely sure. I think it's along this wall. All right. So where the hell am I going? Why we don't need a torch to walk around the city? Could you imagine how annoying that would be? So we're making a left, actually. I think. Right. Don't know if this is where the key is, guys, but... So I'm headed to the Paladin's Guild, and I'm hoping I'll just run across it on the way. I know it's in here, or right outside here, somewhere. Unless, of course, I'm wrong, and just remembering it all wrong, no! Eh. corner here or something. I know it's around here somewhere, damn it. $600. Take it. Skills. For right now, I'm going to increase attack to 30 and parry to 20. Gribbon has reached level 3. Well, his max LP. Oh, we should have done this before resting. That would have been a good idea. Well, I didn't really plan it out, did I? Okay, so he's now 61. Hit points, spell points. We haven't been even having him use spells. Eventually, I guess he'll be our backup healer in case something happens to Amethyst. But that's, you know, eventually. We'll be halfway done with the game by the time we get everything set up, right? Who knows? Level training costs just another 600 gold. Okay, is it 600 every level, or does it go up? Yeah, like I mentioned in the previous episode or two, he is going up 2 levels. So, we want Read Magic Scrolls to be a little higher than this, at least. Use magic. There we go. So pretty much, Paladin, whatever you want to call it, is a hybrid between a warrior and a cleric, so you've kind of be a little good at both, unless you want your paladin to be more of a cleric and a sucky fighter, or for him to be a good fighter with a sucky cleric skill. So I prefer the best of both worlds of paladin type, so that's why I'm splitting this like this. I am pretty much going to focus on attack and parry a little more, though, so the next level, you know, if I remember, I'm going to put into attack and parry. Maximum hit points is now 80. Sweet. I'm stuck at 4. We have got to go to the Tower of the White Wizards. We simply have to. Buster. 243 experience needed for that. Next level. Is that all the gold? I used that much? Oh yeah, I guess it makes sense. Really adds up after a while. Oh, okay, so where is this keyhole? So who gave that to him? Our father? And he wouldn't even give us that key until we got his goblin for him. That bastard. I got a good mind to slap his face all over the place. I'm just wandering around looking for this key. This keyhole, rather. I think it was along like a dead end. I don't think it was supposed to be represented on the map. I figured it would not. I'm over here. Yeah, no, it's not gonna be. No, there's nothing like that, unfortunately. Something here? Where are we? I think it's along, like I said, I have the distinct impression it's along the outskirts of this area. Theme. I love so much of the music in this game. Severely awesome. Eternal Guardians of Light. Ah, here it is. Yes, a rusty old keyhole. And we have an old key. It doesn't say the key is rusty, but it says it is old. So I figured I'd just try this, because this is the closest keyhole. No idea if it's... How would I even have to look at it? Or would I just use the key here? What am I even doing? I just feel like it's a good idea to save. I don't know. Rusty old key. So go use. Oh, we've used it up. What happened? Oh! I never realized. You know what this game needs? Sound effects. Am I advancing away or into? Okay. It also needs a pointer to show you which way you're facing. Cool. Ouch, the chest says. Ooh! In this old chest, you find a piece of the Amberstar and some gold. Amberstar part 2, everybody! Yes, my broodlings. 657 gold, that makes up for one level of Griban's training, plus a little bit more. Piece of Amberstar, yes! Who can take the Amberstar? Well, I've got a vacant area since... Yeah. I'll take it. So, take all the gold. I have to see how much he's, overweight, if any, at this point. Nice, guys. Amberstar Part 2. He is 50 out of 53. He's just about loaded up. Oh, we have a bunch of crap to sell. And what am I doing? Alright, let's get the hell out of here. Sweet. That's a dead end. This way. The shop is here. So we're making a left. I'm not taking this immediate turn, no. Excellent friend. I think silk gets better prices. Items to gold, so we want to sell this, this, this. Does anyone need studded leather? No. Thank you. So I guess one of the orcs was wearing studded leather then. That stud. And 33 gold. Spare hat, saving that. You might notice the letter is, I think, normally 59, now it's 54. I mean, if I really wanted to make a lot of money, I could transfer the item from Griban to Silk and sell, but really, like, who has the patience for this crap? If I was playing by myself and really had no life, like, when you're a kid in, like, junior high, high school and stuff like that, you really have no life. You just... Especially if you don't have tons of friends to hang out with constantly. You, like, spend a lot of time playing video games. Nowadays, you can't be bothered all the time. Oh, we need more sling stones for him. We do. Back home. I might regret this. I might just sell this crowbar, because he's getting full. Oh, you know what? I'm going to sell the mace. Because my next party member is going to be a magic user. I'm not going to be using a mace. So hopefully I don't regret this, but I'm going to sell the mace and the crowbar. And these can carry plenty of stuff. So mace and crowbar, I'll get some more arrows. Silk has... Yeah, give Silk another 21 arrows. Gold. I don't think they break. The mace, I think we found on an orc or somebody. I don't even remember at this point. It's cool, so almost 800 gold from all this crap. I'll switch back to Silk so he can buy stuff. Just curious. I am curious. Oh, we want to... Look at that. Plus we're gonna spend some of it. Okay. Horn helmet is... Look at the most expensive thing. Okay. An axe. It's 376. Trident. You're gonna find, like, probably the most disparity with the expensive items. So a trident for a silk is 2820. A trident for amethyst is 2910. So you'd waste $90 there. For Griban, $29.10 as well. Trazric, $29.70. He must have horrible charisma or something like that. $29.40. Drobaneer. $29.10. What was Silk again? $28.20. Yeah, have Silk buy everything. Selling is a different matter. You have to transfer items back and forth. I just have him buy everything. Because something about him, which I will look at in a second. Items to... Yeah. What did he have? 29? So if I give him 21? I was going to give him 40. No. 29 and 21 is gonna give him 50, not 40, duh. Guess we bought that. And what else do we want? Torches? Gold back. Jobaneer, a torch bearer, I guess. If not carrier. And arrows, trigger band. Ta-da! I mean silk. Not ribbon. Because I actually did give it to Griban. What the hell? Wait, what happened? What did I just do? Did I not? I hit exit, didn't I? Or something. I didn't. Boom. Okay. There we go. 50, and Droba has 27 torches. And he can still carry more stuff. Also, the fact that Amethyst has 11 torches, so we're good on torches. Thanks! See ya. Now I'm pretty sure there's no more guilds here. Where am I? I don't think I want to be here, no. Hope I'm headed the right way. Am I? Wait a second. Yes. Okay, so now we want to rest again, unfortunately. Because we've got Grimmin at 42 out of 80. Now, Silk can level up, I believe. Let me see my little notes here. But I don't feel like trekking all the way back to Twin Lake right now to do this. Although maybe I should. Silk can also level up twice if my notes are correct. Trazric needs 750, and he can level up, but we have to go back to his guild. Okay, so he can level, but we have to go to the Black Wizard's Tower for that. And Jobaneer needs 840. He's not there just yet. Jobaneer and Silk can level up in, what do you call it? Twin Lake. So we have a few things to do in Twin Lake, plus we need to get Trazric some more slingstones. So we might as well just level him up. Plus, in Twin Lake, visit Chandra. Can't forget that. Now I'm just gonna see Gribban gets. Oh, that's right, because he got some mana or magic points or power points as well. Sweet. Oh, not this. So let's see if we can brave the... What do you call it? Second floor. Orlando's wine cellar. Oh. Ouch. This is probably a bit of a smaller episode, but looks like we have passed the 30 minutes. So I'm gonna meet you guys on the stairs down to the second level of this place, and we're gonna explore that next episode. Really, I was just running around. I got the second place of the Amberstar. We got Gribban up two levels. We replenished arrows. We got ourselves back up to full with all our magic and healing, or hit points rather. And stuff. So we have things to do even after this. So thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure. Orlando says, "Give me my wine."